Good morning to all of you. And this is for 10th standard geography. And second lesson is very important, 2-mark question. Jet stream. 2-mark question. 2-mark question. What is jet streams? Listen carefully. First of all, what is jet stream? Jet streams. Here jet streams is the fast moving wind blowing in the narrow zone of upper atmosphere. You know that jet is a very faster wind. It's very faster wind that moving on the upper layer of atmosphere. You know very well that is the earth is wrapped by enveloped by the atmosphere. Here the various gases are found. Here the fast moving wind that is blowing on the upper atmosphere is known as jet streams. And also the air, it is the air current that flows over the atmosphere. Here the fast of the, I mean speed of this wind is 442 per hours. The 442 kilometers, 442 kilometers per hours. This is the speed of the jet streams. This is first point. And then according to the jet stream theory, the onset of southwest monsoon is driven by the shift of subtropical westerlying jet from the plains of India towards the plateau, the Tibetan plateau. Here the according to the onset of southwest monsoon, you know southwest monsoon is very significant monsoons because of the entire India are receiving more than 80% of rainfall from the southwest monsoon. You know southwest monsoons are start from June, July, August, September, continuously 4 months gives the rainfall to the entire India except Tamil Nadu. So here according to the gestation theory, the onset means the beginning of southwest monsoon is driven means a mood by the shift of subtropical westerlying jet from the plains of India towards the Tibetan plateau. So here in the this is a westerlying wind, that the wind is a blows from the subtropical regions of south southern hemisphere towards moves towards northwards, and when it cross the equator due to the Coriolis forces is turned into the westwards and moves towards the Tibetan plateau, means moves towards North India and gives rainfall, and I mean it's a blows over the Arabian Sea, it getting moisture, and when stick the Western Ghats and as well as Eastern Ghats, it gives the rainfall to the India, and it's finally it's go to reach the Himalaya mountains, until the Himalaya mountains. So this is the concept. So this is according to the theory. So the what it says, the theory about the jet streams, that's nothing. According to the jet stream theory, the onset or beginning of the monsoon moved by the shift of subtropical westerlying jet from the plains of India towards the Tibetan plateaus. And the third point is in this point is not given on the book, is my own point. Here it's not my own point, it's a very important point, so taken from the various other books where it could determine the arrival and the departure of monsoon wind of India. So arrival and the departure, DEPATURE, departure of monsoon wind of India. I mean that jet streams are determining factors of arrival of rainfall. I mean that in the wind, when the wind is blowing over India, it call rainfalls. If not blowing the wind, in the India does not receiving the rainfall. That means letters. And that is the meaning of this line. Here it's determined the arrival and dispatch. So dispatch means come to end. When I mean in this wind also determining when southwest monsoon come to end. It's also determining by the jet streams. So it would determine the arrival and departure of the monsoon wind of India. Okay. So this is very important. Two more questions. So listen carefully and copy this on your note. Thank you very much.